So students, today the experiment is estimation of RNA by Orsonnol method, a very good method to determine the concentration of RNA that is present in the unknown solution. So coming to the aim of this experiment, it is to determine the concentration of RNA that is present in the given unknown solution by Orsonnol method. So you are going to Orsonnol reagent. A green color will develop and you are going to take the absorbance of the green color in order to determine the concentration of the RNA. Coming to the principle of this experiment, this is a general reaction of pentoses, pentose sugars, 5-carbon sugars, and it depends also on the concentration of the ferric chloride, which is going to act as a catalyst. So when pentose is heated with concentrated hydrochloric acid, which is present in the Orsonnol reagent, it will be able to form an intermediate which is called as the furfural. And the formed furfural in presence of ferric chloride will give a green colored compound, which is a measurement is taken at 665 nanometer, and this is the reaction for the Orsonnol experiment. So this is the pentose sugar. It's a 5-carbon sugar, that is the ribose molecule. The Orsonnol reagent contains the compound that is the acid concentrated HCl. So the ribose sugar will undergo dehydration, removal of the water molecules. The removal of water molecules will result in the formation of an intermediate, which you call it as the furfural, and the formed furfural will react with the Orsonnol reagent in presence of ferric chloride to form a blue to green condensed product. So this obtained blue to green condensed product color, you're going to measure its absorbance at 665 nanometer. These are the two important reagents which we require for the estimation of RNA. One is the working standard RNA solution, where its concentration is 20 milligram in 100 ml. So this is the concentration in which we have prepared the RNA in 100 ml of the distilled water in a standard flask. So you weigh 20 milligram of RNA and first you dissolve it in some amount of the saline citrate buffer. Because RNA is not directly soluble in water, so we have to solubilize it only with the saline citrate buffer solution. So weigh 20 milligram of the RNA, take it in the standard flask and add little amount of the sodium citrate buffer. Dissolve it thoroughly and then you make it up to 100 ml with the same saline citrate buffer solution, so that the concentration of this standard solution will become 200 microgram per ml. Now coming to the second reagent, it is called as the Orsonnol reagent. Its preparation is, we have to weigh 100 milligram of the anhydrous ferric chloride and dissolve it in 100 ml of concentrated hydrochloric acid. After this has been completely prepared, separately in another one beaker, we are going to prepare 6% Orsonnol in ethanol. No water here, it is 6% Orsonnol prepared in ethanol. So 6 grams of Orsonnol has to be dissolved in 100 ml of the ethanol. But for the experiment, we require only 100 ml of the preparation of concentrated hydrochloric acid with 100 milligram of ferric chloride. So we have to prepare it for 10 ml, and from the 10 ml, you are going to take out 3.5 ml of the Orsonnol and then you are going to mix it in this 100 ml of the concentrated hydrochloric acid, which is already been prepared with the chloride substance. Now coming to the procedure of this experiment, step number one, take a series of test tubes and different aliquots of the working standard RNA solutions with concentrations ranging from 40 to 200 microgram per ml was pipetted out. Then the all the standard tubes, the final volume should be made up to 1 ml with distilled water. You take separately another one fresh test tube, label it as blank, and you prepare the blank solution by pipetting out 1 ml of the distilled water. After that, you take two and tubes and labeled them as unknown 1 and unknown 2. And from the provided unknown solution, you can pipette out two different aliquots of the unknown, like 0.5 ml and 0.7 ml into the two labeled tubes as UK1 and UK2. After that, the volume in both the tubes should be made up to 1 ml with distilled water. Then finally, to your black solution, standard solution, unknown tubes, 4 ml of the arsenol reagent should be added, mixed thoroughly, and all the tubes should be correctly placed in a boiling water bath for 20 minutes. The time limit is 20 minutes in a boiling water bath. So in order to avoid the evaporation of the contents, the marbles are supposed to be placed on top of all the test tubes. So this will prevent the evaporation of the contents. Then after 20 minutes of incubation in the boiling water baths, all the tubes were cooled thoroughly and the developed green color absorbance was measured or noted down at 665 nanometer in a calorimeter against a reagent blank. Once you have finished taking the absorbance, then you can plot a standard graph by taking working standard RNA concentration along the x-axis and absorbance at 665 nanometer along the y-axis. From the standard graph, the concentration of RNA present in the unknown solution can be determined. So this is the observations. You have the serial number 12345 blank tube UK1, UK2. Then this is the volume of the working standard RNA solution ranging from the volume ranging from 0.2 to 1 ml into your series of test tubes labeled as 125, that is your standard blank, will not have any working standard solution, and two unknown aliquots 0.5 ml and 0.7 ml has to be pipetted out. And these are the concentrations ranging from 40 to 200 microgram for the volumes what we have taken from 0.2 to 1 ml. Then here it is to be determined, so we have placed the question mark. After pipetting your working standard and your unknown solution, now you have to pipette the distilled water with volumes from 0.8 ml to 0.2 ml to all your working standard and 1 ml as your blank solution, and make up the 0.5 ml of your UK1 with 0.5 ml of distilled water and 0.7 ml of UK2 with 0.3 ml of the distilled water, so that the total volume in all your tubes comes only to 1 ml. Then add the arsenol reagent 4 ml to all your tubes from the blank to the standard as well as to your unknown tubes. Mix them thoroughly and place the tubes in a boiling water bath for 20 minutes and place the marbles on top of them. After 20 minutes, remove your tubes, cool it down thoroughly and take the absorbance at 665 nanometer, and you can note down all your absorbance values in the tabular column. Once you get the absorbance, now you can start to do your calculation. The unknown UK1 volume what you have taken is 0.5 ml. So 0.5 ml of the RNA solution will correspond to X microgram, which you must have got it from your tabular, from your graph sheet. So for 0.5 ml, if X is the microgram concentration, then for 1 ml of the solution, what will be its concentration? Note it down as A value. Similarly, for the second aliquot of 0.7 ml of your second RNA solution, the concentration is Y microgram, which you would have got it from the standard graph. So therefore, if 0.7 ml is having Y microgram, then 1 ml of your unknown solution will have how much? So you find it out and write it as B value. Then finally, to get the complete concentration of the RNA that is present in the unknown solution, the concentration for UK1 and concentration of UK2 has to be added together and divided by 2 will give you the concentration of your unknown solution RNA, and the units in which it has to be represented is microgram per ml. So finally, coming to the result, after calculating, the amount of RNA present in the given unknown solution was found to be, whatever is the answer we are getting, that must be the concentration of the RNA which has to be reported in microgram for MS. And Sashidhar Rao book is the textbook which we have used in order to complete the reference.
Going to see estimation of RNA by Orsinal method. So in this experiment, the principle is that in the RNA, you have the sugar which is called as the ribose sugar. So the ribose sugar, in presence of the acid, it will undergo dehydration to form an intermediate called as the furfural. And that formed furfural as an intermediate will react with Orsinal reagent to form a bluish green color complex. So this complex, what has been formed, you are going to take its absorption maxima at 665 nanometer. So coming to the requirements for this experiment, first thing what we require is going to be the working standard RNA solution. So the concentration what we have used for preparing this solution is 20 milligram in 100 ml of the distilled water we have to prepare this one. Then the second component what we require is the unknown solution, for which we have to determine its concentration. Then we will require some amount of the distilled water. So to start with the experiment, we have taken series of test tubes, labeling them from 1 to tube number 5, indicating the volume what we have to take. And each one volume of the standard solution what we have taken, the concentration will be ranging from 40 micrograms and can go up to 200 micrograms. And this is a blank test tube where we are going to take only 1 ml of the distilled water. From the unknown, two aliquots are going to be taken with a volume of 0.5 ml and 0.7 ml into each of the test tubes respectively. So once we pipette out with the standard solutions and the unknown, next thing is we have to make it up to 1 ml with the distilled water. After making all the tubes to 1 ml with distilled water, and then you have to add 4 ml of the Orsinal reagent to all the test tubes. Shake them thoroughly, and then we have to place it in the boiling water bath for 20 minutes. After 20 minutes is over, you will be getting the green color. Take the tubes outside, cool the tubes thoroughly, and you can take the absorbance. So to start with, let us take first the standard solution. So the first tube, the volume is 0.2 ml. So we can adjust our micropipette and we can keep it as 200 microliters so that we can take 0.2 ml. Now always when you are pipetting, you have to go from the lower concentration going up to the higher concentration. So 20 milligram in 100 ml we have taken the standard solution. So accordingly, if I take now from the standard solution 0.2 ml, then it will correspond to a concentration of 40 microgram per ml. So the first test tube we have taken 0.2 ml of the working standard RNA solution. So in the tube number 2, we are going to take 400 microliters, which is corresponding to 0.4 ml, and its concentration will be 80 microgram per ml. So this is 0.4 ml in the second test tube. Then we can increase the volume to now 0.6 ml. So I am adjusting my micropipette and keeping it at 600 microliter. So tube number 3, I am pipetting out now 0.6 ml of the working standard RNA solution. Then tube number 4, 0.8 ml. So 0.8 ml I am going to add into tube number 4. So this is 0.8 ml of the working standard. Then coming to tube number 5, we are going to take 1 ml of the working standard solution, which will be having a concentration of 200 micrograms per ml. So this is tube number 5. So we have completed pipetting out the working standard solution. Then now we will add the distilled water. So you know that distilled water, what we are adding is to make up the solution in all the tubes to 1 ml. So initially to start with, we will start with the blank tube. In the blank, there is no standard. We are taking only 1 ml of the distilled water. Okay. Now, in tube number 1, we have taken 0.2 ml of the standard. That means we are supposed to add 0.8 ml of the distilled water. So I am going to change the volume and make it as 0.8 ml. So I am adding now 0.8 ml in the first test tube. So now the total volume in my first tube has come to 1 ml. So next tube 0.4 ml of the standard, so I should add now 0.6 ml of my distilled water. So that the total volume in the tube will come to 1 ml. Then next tube it is 0.6 ml of the standard, so I should add now 0.4 ml of the water. So that the total volume will come to 1 ml. So just shake the tubes thoroughly so that there will be complete mixture of the water and the standard solution. Fourth tube, as you know, we have taken 0.8 ml of the standard, so I should add now 0.2 ml of the water so that the total volume will become now 1 ml. As you know, tube number 5, no requirement of addition of water because we have taken already 1 ml of the distilled water. Now we have to prepare our unknown solution. So two aliquots I have noted down. One is 0.5 ml, the other one is 0.7 ml. So let me adjust my micropipette to 0.5 ml so that I will be able to take my unknown solution. So first, let me add the unknown solution in the first tube. I have changed my micropipette to 0.5 ml. So I am taking the unknown solution and I am adding it to UK1, that is unknown one, 0.5 ml. Now I am increasing it to 700 microliters so that it will correspond to 0.7 ml. So that I am going to take as my second RNA aliquot sample in the tube number UK2. So I have pipetted now the samples. Now I have to add the distilled water. Remember, first unknown one, 0.5 ml of the standard means I have to add now 0.5 ml of the water so that the total volume in my tube will come to 1 ml. So I am just taking 0.5 ml of the water and I am adding it to UK1. Then I am going to take now 0.3 ml of the distilled water. Why 0.3 ml of distilled water? Because in unknown 2 we have taken 0.7 ml of the unknown solution. So I should add 0.3 ml of the water so that the total volume in the tubes will come now to 1 ml. So you can see that the tubes, in all the tubes we have made it up to 1 ml. Standard, blank as well as the unknown. So now to all the test tubes you are supposed to add 4 ml of the arsenol reagent. The preparation of arsenol reagent is by adding 100 mg of the ferric chloride in 100 ml of the acid, that is HCl. Then you have to prepare 6% arsenol. And from 6% of arsenol what we have prepared, we have to take 3.5 ml and use it for the experiment. So I am adding now arsenol reagent, 4 ml in each of the tubes. So I am adding in tube number 3. Number 5, it is 20 I should add. Next is the blank solution. Blank, there is no any standard, so it should take the color of the reagent. So the color of the reagent is yellow, so blank will remain yellow. And all the other tubes where you have added the standard and the unknown RNA, it should react and give us green color. So this is UK1 and this is UK2. So we have completed adding up the reagent to all the tubes. So we have to shake it thoroughly and place it in the boiling water bath. So the water should be boiling. and I'm going to place all my tubes inside the water bath. So temperature must be 100 degrees. So it must be a boiling water bath. Now after placing it, incubation time is 20 minutes. So for a long time you are keeping your tubes in the boiling water bath. So there are many chances that the contents can evaporate. So that is why we keep a marble on top of the tube so that the contents will not change. So we have kept it, leave it aside the tubes for 20 minutes and after the reaction is over, remove your tubes. After 20 minutes, remove your tubes, cool your tubes thoroughly and then you take the absorbance at 665 nanometers. And the blank solution and the unknowns, the tubes after boiling, we have removed them and you can see the color, that is a green colored complex which has been formed after the reaction of the ribose sugar with the arsenol reagent. So you can see that there is a good gradation in the colors in the standards because you have taken from lower concentration and have gone till the higher concentration. This is the blank. In the blank you can see, as I told, it will be taking only the color of the reagent because there is no any RNA added over here, and these are the two unknown tube aliquots. Now the color, green color complex what we have got will be having an absorbance at 665 nanometer. Since at 665 nanometer our colorimeter filters are not there, I am placing it at 670 nanometer. So first step is that I have kept the tube which contains the distilled water and I set the equipment to auto zero. So the next step is I will take the blank solution and then set the equipment to zero readings. So as you know, after removing it from the water bath, we have cooled them thoroughly. Okay, so the tubes all have been cooled up and now I am transferring the blank solution into the cuvette. I am cleaning the outer surface of the cuvette thoroughly and I am placing it inside the sample holder. So now the blank is showing some absorbance of 0.03. Let me press auto zero and set the blank reading to 00 value. So I have set the blank to a value of 0.00. Now I take another fresh cuvette and now I am going to start to take the readings for the standard values. So this is the first standard reading for which I am going to take. So I am removing the blank solution and I will keep my tube number 1 solution. So the absorbance what I have got is 0.12. You can make a note of it. It is 0.12 is the absorbance. So now we will go ahead with the next value. So I will keep the blank in this cuvette sample folder. Transfer back the solution and then I will now take the tube number 2 solution now. So tube number 2 concentration is 80 microgram. I will take the solution in the cuvette. I have transferred it. Then I am going to place it in the sample folder. So I am removing the blank and placing my tube number 2 solution. So it's now showing me 0.20 is the absorbance value for tube number 2. So I'll place black and transfer my tube number 2 solution here. Then very gently you handle the cuvette. Then we'll go to tube number 3. So the readings for tube number 3, let us check it out. So tube number 3, the readings is 0.25. Now we will go with the next tube solution. So there is some fluctuations. So next is tube number 4. So we can note down the readings. This is for tube number 4, it is 0.32. Then I am placing back the blank we will take the last standard solution reading, that is going to be fifth tube with the highest concentration of 200 microgram per ml. So you can note down the last tube reading. So I am removing it, placing back the solution, and now the reading for the last tube is 0.27. Okay, so now we will take the readings for the unknown solution. So I am transferred the fifth tube solution. Then we can rinse the cuvette once, because we are going to take the absorbance for the unknown solution. So we can rinse it once. Then we will take the unknown one reading. So this is unknown one solution one. So 3/4 of the cuvette has to be filled with the solution. So unknown one, I am getting the absorbance of 0.20. So I am transferring back the UK one solution into its respective tube. Now we will take for UK two. So this is unknown two. So let us take the last tube reading. So the last tube reading shows me 0.27. So we have taken the readings also. Now students, remember, you are supposed to now plot the graph by taking concentration along the x-axis and absorbance along the y-axis. So with the standard values what we have got, plot the graph, cut the unknown values, and you can report the result to us. Thank you, students.